is coming to Philadelphia and the First Union Spectrum on May the 1st. Tickets on sale this Friday morning at the First Union Center box office and all Ticketmaster outlets. Plus, you have the opportunity to meet Bam Bam Bigelow and Saturn from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. at Tower Records in Cherry Hill, New Jersey. And, of course, Bam Bam Bigelow will be facing this man, Hardcore Hack, this Sunday at Spring Stampede.
Hardcore Hack looks like he's already involved and in some kind of entanglement.
Seems to be wrapped up in something, probably barbed wire.
You know, when you say hardcore, when you talk about extreme, to me, Mike, that translates into the lack of science. The lack of science becomes nothing but raw brutality. This guy should be in a straitjacket.
And these two competitors that are ready to square off on WCW Thunder, Hack and Mikey Whipwreck, certainly no strangers to each other. And we will go into detail on the background, their history. But we want to remind you that coming up this Saturday night on the Superstation, for over a quarter of a century, it's been the TBS weekend tradition. And WCW Saturday night on the eve of Spring Stampede will feature First Family members Barbarian and Hugh Morris. Plus, you'll see Conan and a return match. Rick Steiner and Fit Finley join Scott Hudson and myself at 6.05 p.m. Eastern this Saturday night right here on TBS.
Now, you're going to have to clue me in on the chick out here. I'm confused about what she's on about, and I know you know.
Well, that is Chastity, who is Raven's sister. But at last month's Uncensored pay-per-view, there was a three-way King of Hardcore match between Bam Bam Bigelow, Hack, and Raven. And at the conclusion of that match, Chastity turned on her own brother and is now aligned with Hack. Does that straighten it up for you?
Raven, you know, with his confused childhood, probably pulled all the heads off her dolls when he was a kid or something.
And I can tell you that Bam Bam Bigelow is steamed after this last Monday on Nitro when he received that shot from the fire extinguisher in the face. You know, Bigelow was a part of that three-way match, but he really wasn't involved in the finish of the match. So Bigelow feels like he still has something in store when it comes to challenging the King of Hardcore, Hack, and Bigelow gets that opportunity this Sunday at Spring Stampede.
That's gonna be a match. When I watch guys like Hack wrestle Bam Bam Bigelow, I really appreciate my golf bag.
And how are you hitting them?
Long and straight.
David Duvall, beware.
The green jacket, size 50 ready.
This is only the second WCW match for 25-year-old Mikey Whipwreck. He debuted back at Uncensored in a spectacular cruiserweight title bout against Kidman. Now, the obvious drawback to the high-risk cruiserweight style is injury. And of course, it was a severely bruised heel for Mikey Whipwreck in that match against Kidman. He's been sidelined several weeks, now back in action here in WCW.
I tell you, pain is part of the game, and you know, it amazed me over the years how you get used to it. I mean, there was sometimes I had championship defenses in the evening. I literally had to be pushed out of bed and rolled to a massage table. I mean, the pain was so, you know, intense in your lower back. You can't get up and walk, and people don't realize this is a brutal sport, and these guys wrestle in pain every day. When it takes its toll, it's just a matter of time. Life expectancy of a guy like Hack isn't very long.
Yet to come this evening right here on the Superstation in our main event, Booker T to defend the world's TV title against Chris Jericho. Plus, we will also see in one-on-one competition two men that will be meeting at Spring Stampede in a tag team match, because later tonight it's Raven versus the Canadian Crippler Chris Benoit.
That's going to be a good one. You know, I'm watching this Chastity out here, and I mean, definitely distracting Whipwreck. Mr. Whipwreck, I mean, it's hard to keep your eyes on Hack when you see this blonde flashing back and forth, dressed in bright colors. You know, over the years, people would say, why do managers always dress so outrageous? Why does Jimmy Hart wear bright colors? Strictly for distraction, and it works.
And it has worked for Hardcore Hack as he takes Whipwreck, sends him out to the floor. Beware, Chastity is out there with kendo stick in hand, but she puts down the kendo stick and goes over and rakes the eyes in the face of Mikey Whipwreck.
Most vicious creatures on the face of the planet.
These two men very familiar with each other. They've been involved in several high-profile bouts through the years, yet this is their first meeting in World Championship Wrestling.
I tell you, this Hack, you know, I don't really know him, but I've seen him a couple of times. He's a big guy. He's upside down now, but he's still about 6'6".
He is, in about 250-plus pounds, and he just got stood on his head by the cruiserweight Mikey Whipwreck.
I tell you, better not stop. Yeah, that's a keep going.
He took a side Russian leg sweep and just took the back of Hack's head and drove him right into the safety rail.
What he's gonna do now, Hack is a big guy, much bigger than I thought when I first, you know, heard about him. So you get a guy like this down, you gotta keep going.
High risk move off the top. He connected. Larry, we've got to step aside for another break. Cover gets two. Oh. Kick out by Hack, but when we return here on Thunder, more of Hack and Whipwreck. Welcome back, everyone, to Thunder. Mike Tenay and Larry Zbyszko with you on the Superstation. Hardcore Hack, Mikey Whipwreck, Chastity involved at ringside. Spring Stampede just 4 days away. Larry, things are on fire in World Championship Wrestling.
Oh, yeah, and the world's talking about the first time you got 4 men in the ring after one prize. I can't wait.
And don't forget about the special referee, the Macho Man Randy Savage, who promises that there will be a winner in that Four Corners match at Spring Stampede. Ric Flair, Hollywood Hogan, Diamond Dallas Page, and the return of Sting as well.
Of course, now Sting, here's a man I haven't seen for, oh man! I'm just gonna talk about Sting, should be a man in 100% physical shape. Should be injury free, unlike Mr. Whipwreck and Mr. Hack.
Well, Hack just took the body of Mikey Whipwreck and draped it across the steel guardrail. Whipwreck, that's what they said.
No, I said it wrong.
Oh, and then came across with that leg drop. And then it was the momentum of Whipwreck that drove him face first again into the steel. Now tosses him back into the ring. You know, we've talked about World Championship Wrestling athletes being in demand, and yes, Bret the Hitman Hart will be on later tomorrow night after Conan O'Brien. We can also tell you that Hollywood Hogan is going to be on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno this Friday night. Ric Flair is going to be throwing out the first pitch as we see Whipwreck roll in and get two before the kick out. Ric Flair will be throwing out the first pitch at the St. Louis Cardinals Milwaukee Brewers baseball game tomorrow. And of course, Flair is going to be in St. Louis for the great first day on sale as World Championship Wrestling brings Slamboree to the TWA Dome. And Flair will be at the TWA Dome box office this Friday morning.
And I tell you, Hack or Whipwreck may be in the emergency room if this keeps going like this.
Uh-oh, got the steel chair, put the boots to Hack in the corner. Mikey Whipwreck, another boot to the head, and, well, we've been talking about baseball season. It's batter up. Now he's going to run across the ring. Oh, his momentum, and drop kicks the chair right into the face of Hack.
You can save that punt for football season.
Just nowhere to go for Hack, sandwiched in the corner. Whipwreck with the chair across the face and all of his weight behind the dropkick. Rolls him back out. You'll notice that the chair is in place under the back. Oh! High risk move, and all he caught was steel.
Now that's a wreck.
That's a Whipwreck.
Whatever. You can see the toll it takes on these guys. I mean, this is a brutal form of competition, and one I don't envy.
And we know that the Beast from the East is ready for a hardcore matchup with Hack this Sunday at Spring Stampede. Hardcore Hack tries to follow up the edge that he has. Gonna lift Whipwreck up, slingshots him, hangs him out now with a front suplex, just drapes him across the top steel cable. Up on top, catches him with the leg drop.
It's a big guy coming down off that top rope, and you can see the result here. Mr. Whipwreck, he's not moving.
You can even see that Hack is slow to follow up. Scoop and a slam. The toll that the physical brutality from Mikey Whipwreck has taken on Hack has even slowed his offense down. Now the chair in place, slingshot, leg drop.
Brother,
you're speechless, Larry.
Give me a tea time anytime.
Uh-oh, calling now for the kendo stick, and Chastity tosses it in.
Oh, right the knee.
Whipwreck using the steel chair to stop it. Oh! Nailed it again in the head with that Singapore cane. I think he ducked that one. He did. Side Russian leg sweep while he took the stick and wrapped it around his neck. Cover, two, and three.
But dude, that was surprising. Hacked a couple of good shots in the head, but it was a nice movie through in, and speaking of God throwing in, here comes the beast.
Here comes the beast from the east, Big Bam Bam Bigelow. Oh, just nailed Hack with the right hand on the floor.
And he's got fire coming out of his head.
He sure does, brought him back into the ring. Where's he going to take him? He's going to take him to the Garden State. Oh, a one-way trip to New Jersey with the greetings from Asbury Park. Chastity with the stick from behind.
That's a waste of time.
Oh, absolutely no effect with the kendo stick to the back of this huge Bam Bam Bigelow.
He's going to hit her.
She ducks out of the ring, luckily for Chastity.
That would have been a 300-yard drive.
And Bigelow promises that he will see Hack this Sunday when these two collide at Spring Stampede.
Hey, look at the face of Bigelow.